After years of speculating about Eugenia's appearance, people are feeling hopeless about her not wanting to change.
I don't know if me being positive online towards her, is that the right thing to do?
People just want the best for her.
Why is no one giving her, like, getting her off the internet and, like, helping her?
But Eugenia seems focused on calling out her haters.
I don't know, guys. I'm just kinda like, if you want me to end my life so bad, if you don't watch me, it'll be like I'm dead already.
Eugenia Cooney has spoken up, but fans are still not having it. Eugenia Cooney is no stranger to controversy on YouTube. For years, many YouTubers have given their opinion on her videos and her lifestyle. In January 2019, Eugenia uploaded a video of herself in a Kingdom Hearts cosplay. In her video, many people commented on her appearance and begged her to seek help. Eugenia had always been surrounded by controversy about her figure and weight, but things seem to have taken a turn for the worse. Eugenia, you have such a wonderful personality. Please find the support you need to get better. We will celebrate your success with you. I am speechless. I've been watching in the shadows for years, and today my heart sank. You are such a beautiful person, and it's evident you are struggling with something so much bigger than we can imagine. Eugenia, you know you can't go on like this. You're such a beautiful, loving soul. I pray you get better. The world needs positive people like you. We can't lose you. Your recovery would so powerful. I pray it happens before it's too late. Not long after Eugenia had posted the video, she posted an update to her Twitter. Hi guys, I appreciate the concern. I'm taking a break from social media and voluntarily working on this with my doctor privately. Please respect that. Eugenia disappeared from social media for a number of months. She made her return in early July 2019 in Shane Dawson's documentary, The Return of Eugenia Cooney. Eugenia posted a video to her own channel shortly after called, I'm Back. After this video, Eugenia's fans were hopeful they would see her continue to heal and continue on a path to success. However, this doesn't seem to have been the case. On May 21st, her friend Johnny Gilbert put out a video addressed to her, Dear Eugenia Cooney. In the video, Johnny said he had been friends with Eugenia since 2014, and even though they had never been close, he still cared for her. He said Eugenia got more hate online than anyone he'd ever seen. Johnny said it was hard to watch Eugenia have health issues on camera, and he felt helpless.
I don't know what to do. I don't know if me liking her photos or being, you know, like positive online towards her, is that the right thing to do?
He said he thought about DMing her, but felt he could convey his emotions more clearly on camera. He ended the video by saying he's concerned for her well-being. He wanted people to be more compassionate, and he wished Eugenia the best. The next day, Eugenia addressed Johnny's video on her Twitch stream. She said she felt he was nicer to her than a lot of people who have made videos about her. She said,
I really appreciate him caring about me and stuff, and not trying to make me into like this evil villain, because I feel like sometimes some of these videos can be like that and everything.
People were annoyed she didn't address the issue Johnny made the video about. She repeats herself a lot, but never actually addresses the real issues and just says, oh, I appreciate it, he's really nice, but avoids the topic of EDs. Don't worry about me, I'm fine. Okay. She keeps saying how it's nice, but the video was literally him expressing his concern for her. It wasn't meant to be nice. It wasn't a compliment. It was him begging her to get help. On May 30th, Eugenia uploaded a video called Summer Outfits 2021. The 18-minute video featured Eugenia showing off different outfits she planned to wear this summer, ranging from dresses and skirts to bathing suits. The video received more than double the number of dislikes than the number of likes. People were shocked to see the state Eugenia was in. It's sad to know that the majority of people watching this poor girl are doing it purely out of a morbid curiosity. I understand because I'm constantly checking up to make sure she's still here too. Every couple of months I come back and hope she's still around. It is truly heartbreaking. You can literally see where every bone connects to the next. You are officially a bad influence on any minor that is exposed to you. This human is like 60 pounds with literally 0% body fat. Can someone explain to me how she is alive and even talking? This seems like a medical miracle. Some questioned whether her hair was real. I'm a hairstylist, and this is not her real hair as she claims. There's no way that you can deprive your body of nutrition and have healthy hair. The fact that she's so careful about the placement of her hair strands and moves as to not let her hair sway or have any movement at all convinces me her hair is fake. headpiece holding her extensions. There is no way a malnutrition body can have hair, period. We've seen these ED girls with no hair at all. Others believe there could be something more scandalous going on. The part where she's showing the bracelet and has it so far back and left so her arm is showing is hilarious. She's literally making content for the fetish creeps, and that's it. The fact she is catering to fetishists on YouTube knowing kids are watching too makes me so indescribably ill. Eugenia, these outfits were really cute, but regarding the swimsuit, I just want to say you don't have to do this. You don't have to always cater to the creeps who want you to stay sick like this. Some people called her out for acting like her situation wasn't a big deal. You're sick, you refuse to get help, and you're teaching young girls that it's okay to have an ED. I wouldn't want my daughter to watch your channel just because of how she could start to try and copy you because she might look up to you. For some reason, people online just love to make really big deals about things. She's the queen of denial and gaslighting. Eugenia being passive about the swimsuit. You know exactly why people get upset about it. When you got out of rehab, you acknowledged your body at its low weight could be triggering. Now you act like you have no idea? You're not fooling anyone with the lies. Others doing swimsuit videos are okay because they are healthy and don't have bones protruding out to trigger people. You yourself seek these images out, so you know exactly what you are doing. You also specifically chose the most revealing outfit for your thumbnail, and you're going to act like you don't know and exposing yourself once again after the shoe haul incident. Seriously? This wasn't the first time Eugenia was called out for her appearance and actions online. On May 7th, she uploaded a video called My Shoe Collection 2021. This video also received a high number of dislikes. It showed Eugenia sitting on a chair, showing off the different pairs of shoes she owns. However, in multiple instances, her underwear is clearly visible on screen as she is wearing a skirt while trying on shoes. People weren't convinced this was accidental. You can't tell me she doesn't know what she's doing when she's matched her eyeshadow to her underwear. Sigh. That's actually an awesome shoe collection. Too bad it's overshadowed by all that body checking and crotch flashing. She's not even looking at the camera. She's looking at the viewfinder, body checking, and literally making sure the angle is right to expose herself. Jesus f***ing Christ, this is just getting horrific. Others were more concerned for her health. This is definitely your most depraved moment. If this isn't rock bottom for you, I'm scared to find out what is. As a kid, when I started watching you and supporting you, I didn't eat and starve myself to look exactly like you. But now, I value my health. I'm glad for breaking out of that phase. A month prior to posting her shoe collection video, Eugenia uploaded a video called Addressing the Hate. In the video, she pulled up comments from concerned viewers. Many comments discussed possible health issues and warned her that some of these issues could be fatal. Some comments turned particularly mean. Throughout the video, Eugenia repeatedly said she's not going to lose her life and she doesn't understand the hate she gets.
If some people get shocked by me or whatever, I mean, I don't know, I can't always really help that really.
Eugenia said people don't have to watch her videos if they don't like her.
I don't know, guys, I'm just kinda like, if you want me to end my life so bad, if you don't watch me, it'll be like I'm dead already.
One person compared her to a victim of the horrific historical events that took place in Germany in the 1930s and 1940s.
Guys, like, the whole is really serious. I mean, luckily, like, I obviously wasn't even, like, alive when the happened, but luckily I'm not a Holocaust victim, but I feel really bad for anyone that was.
People were alarmed by how much she seemed to enjoy the negative comments. The way she absolutely lights up when they said she is shockingly thin. I used to have Anna and I would love when people would say stuff like, you look so sick, or you're so skinny, or you need help, because that was telling me I was losing weight and it was noticeable. These comments definitely fuel her ED. Some people felt she was being dismissive to her commenters. We don't hate you, we're scared for you, stop gaslighting us. I feel gaslit. She's talking to the audience as if nothing's wrong and we're all crazy for thinking anything is wrong. On June 1st, Eugenia was a topic on the H3 podcast with Ethan Klein and Trisha Paytas. They spoke about her summer outfits video being number 26 on the trending page.
So wait, the trending page is curated.
Oh yeah, that's the trending YouTube. Page
so
is curated.
Oh, well there.
Yeah, so they straight up
are they've given the green, someone has manually reviewed this.
So they're like, how is YouTube promoting this?
They discussed Eugenia leaving the platform.
Why is no one giving her, like, getting her off the internet and, like, helping her?
They discussed whether they would be as concerned for someone who is morbidly obese as they were for Eugenia. Trisha said their own perception of health and beauty is warped because they said when they were younger, Eugenia's videos would have encouraged them to live a similar unhealthy lifestyle. Trisha also commented on people holding Eugenia accountable.
I think it's good comments and people are holding her accountable because clearly people in her life aren't. They're not trying to like help her in any way, you know what I mean? But there's only so much you can do.
Trisha said they believed Eugenia had gained weight and the discoloration on her legs seemed to be gone. 2 days later, Eugenia addressed the video on her Twitch stream. She said she believed Trisha was being nice while talking about her.
So I appreciate that, you know, she agreed like with what I always say essentially that, you know, honestly, I really am just kind of like living my life, guys.
People in the comments called her out for cherry picking what she wanted to hear. She literally only likes Trisha because she was enabling her ED in the clip. Wow, for someone who has or had an ED themselves, Trisha sure hit all the things you shouldn't say about someone with anorexia. Damn. Eugenia must have been absolutely ecstatic, and you can tell by how she reacted to what they said. On July 2nd, Eugenia uploaded a new video titled Addressing the Rumors About Me. In her video, she addressed the rumors which said she had secret deals going on with some of her Twitch subscribers, where they would pay her to make certain types of content. She claimed this is false and said any content in her videos or streams are not to please specific people.
It's really not as complicated as some people make it into. I don't know, guys. Like, I also can't really control like when people do tip. I can tell you guys there's definitely no weird secret deals going on or anything like that.
Eugenia also addressed the rumors that her hair is fake or that she wears a wig or extensions and showed her hair to the camera, moving it around to prove that her hair is real. She brought up the situation where her underwear was shown on screen and in pictures and claimed it was an accident.
There's been like some times here or there where my underwear has kind of like accidentally shown in like videos or photos. Regardless of like what some people want to say and some people want to think, I totally get that like maybe it looked on purpose to some people, but it honestly never was.
Eugenia didn't believe it was a big deal.
I don't really view it as that big of a deal because it's not like I was exposing any private body parts or that I was, you know, showing anything, even though it was an accident. It's not like anything like beyond like what would show in a bathing suit was like exposed or anything like that.
Later in the video, she addressed a similar rumor where she allegedly photoshopped inappropriate body parts out of her pictures. She brought up an example where she wore a low-cut dress and people believed she had photoshopped her chest to hide certain body parts. Eugenia said the rumor was false and said she wasn't good at Photoshop. She also addressed the rumors about not caring for her dog, having seizures on live streams, and having severe health issues because of her coughing in videos. She finished her video by saying she's okay with people not believing her.
If any of you guys don't want to believe me, then that's okay, and I'm sorry that I make you upset. This is the truth that I'm telling you, but I guess you're allowed to believe whatever you want to believe.
So, what's the big issue? A lot of health problems can stem from neglecting your body. Eugenia isn't the first influencer to have issues with their health and lifestyle choices. In December 2020, German influencer Josie Maria passed away from complications of an ED. Throughout the final years of her life, Josie shared photos of herself and her experience battling the illness. While on vacation with a friend, Josie passed away after developing circulatory problems due to her illness. She openly spoke about her illness, was a strong advocate for getting healthier, and wanted her followers to join her journey of recovery. I also want to say that we should not hide ourselves away, no matter what psychological illnesses we have. Karen Carpenter is another celebrity who lost her life to an ED. The Carpenters were one of the top-selling American musical acts of all time, reaching peak popularity in the 70s and 80s. However, behind the scenes, Karen struggled with low self-esteem, resulting in an ED. Karen's struggle began just after high school when she was dieting, which only got worse when she began to tour. When you're on the road, it's hard to eat, period. On top of that, it's rough to eat well. We don't like to eat before a show because I can't stand singing with a full stomach. You never get to dinner until like midnight, and if you eat heavy, you're not going to sleep, and you're going to be a balloon. After seeing photos of herself from a concert and thinking they were unflattering, Karen tried to lose even more weight. She changed her eating habits and began to wear more revealing outfits, causing concern from her friends and fans. Some fans began to speculate she was suffering from physical illnesses that were causing her to look gaunt. After an unsuccessful marriage, Karen's illness took a turn for the worse. Karen used thyroid medication that wasn't prescribed to her, which would increase her metabolism and cause her to lose weight faster. After an intervention from a doctor, Karen started eating a healthy diet again and began to put on weight. However, she continued to struggle secretly, using substances to make herself sick. On February 4th, 1983, Karen passed away at the age of 32. Doctors didn't know about her substance use until her autopsy came back. Her cause of death was revealed to be heart failure due to or as a consequence of her ED. Her psychotherapist, Stephen Levenkron, said he didn't know about her substance use. He said she had always assured him in their phone calls that she was maintaining her weight without the use of substances. Levenkron said overuse of particular substances can slowly dissolve the heart muscles. He said he didn't believe Karen thought that taking the substance would be harmful, but it accidentally took her life. When Karen lost her life, people began to take EDs more seriously. In the late 60s and 70s, British model Twiggy's ultra-thin figure became aspirational for young women at the time. Karen's passing brought media attention to EDs, and for the first time, showed how life-threatening they could be. Since then, more celebrities have shared their experiences struggling with EDs, helping to spread public awareness and understanding. So, what can you do if you or someone you know is struggling with an ED? NEDA is the largest nonprofit organization dedicated to supporting individuals and families affected by EDs. They can help connect people with local resources and help family members learn how to support their loved ones. NEDA has an online chat, a helpline, and a text line. If you or someone you know is in crisis and needs help immediately, you can text NEDA at 741-741 to be connected with a trained volunteer at their crisis text line. Overall, this is a tricky situation. People with EDs often do not recognize or acknowledge the situation they are in. Eugenia has gotten help once before, but she seems to be back to her unhealthy lifestyle. In times like this, family members or other trusted friends can be critical in helping a loved one with an ED, but it's unclear who Eugenia trusts right now and who she is willing to open up to. What do you think about this situation? Let me know in the comments below.